Combo Breaker!
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is GamerLCD, and I've got another World of Warcraft Warlords of Draenor video for you guys. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at the Death Knight's level 100 talents, as well as some new talents that were introduced in the Warlords of Draenor beta. And we're also going to be taking a look at their new glyphs that have been implemented into the beta so far. So let's go ahead and get started. First up, we have a new talent in the level 56 tier called Plaguebearer, but you also might notice that there aren't any other new talents in this tier. And that's simply because they had to add Plaguebearer because they removed an iconic ability from Death Knights during ability pruning, which was Blood Boil. And the ability that used to be here in place of Plaguebearer was Roiling Blood. So because we don't have Roiling Blood anymore, they just baked all of Blood Boil's abilities or, you know, effects into Pestilence now. And so what they had to do was basically remove that talent and come up with a new one to give Death Knight since we don't have Blood Boil anymore. So this talent is called Plaguebearer, and it is a passive ability. Now, Death Coil and Frost Strike also infect your target, adding 4 seconds to the duration of Frost Fever and Blood Plague, as well as adding an additional snack to Necrotic Plague. So this is a very, very powerful ability for single target fights, obviously. It acts similar to what Festering Strike did right now on live servers for Unholy DPS Death Knights, in which every single time you cast Festering Strike, it adds a few seconds to the durations of Blood Plague and Frost Fever. So this is going to be a very, very powerful talent for single target damage fights and raid encounters and dungeon fights and stuff like that. Unholy Blight is still going to be very, very competitive for AoE fights with a lot of adds and stuff like that, but for overall, I think that Plaguebearer is going to be a very, very good ability for single target fights. Plague Leech is still going to be a useless ability. Nothing new in the level 57 tier, nothing new in the 58 tier, except that you guys might notice that our Rune Regen tier, which is now level 60, is no longer level 75. So they moved it up a little bit so that way leveling Death Knights can get access to their Rune Regeneration a little bit earlier. I still don't agree with this tier, guys. I think it's pretty much useless, and Blizzard seems to want to defend it and keep it there, even though every single Death Knight ever has said they don't want it there, but I'm not going to argue with him anymore. Level 75 tiered, there's really nothing new here except that Death Pack has been reworked a little bit because DPS Death Knights lost a, or not DPS Death Knights, but Frost and Blood Death Knights lost the ability to summon a ghoul, so you no longer have access to one of your most powerful DPS cooldowns anymore. So they had to rework the ability a little bit. It says before, you sacrificed your ghoul in order to regain some health. But now the ability has been reworked a little bit. It is still an instant ability. It still is on a 2-minute cooldown, but since it no longer has a ghoul, it kind of has like a double-edged sword effect to it. So whenever you use the ability, it heals the Death Knight for 52% of their max health, but as a side effect, it also absorbs all incoming healing equal to 50% of the amount healed for 15 seconds. So basically for 15 seconds, it kind of acts for like purgatory a little bit. So you know how purgatory, when the effect activates, you're going to die in 3 seconds unless your healers are able to heal you for the amount of fatal damage that you took. And the Death Pack now acts in a similar way, in which that every single time you activate this ability, you're healed for 52% of your maximum health, but as a side effect, your healers are going to have to heal you for 50% of the amount healed over 15 seconds. If they don't, well, I guess it really doesn't matter. The duration is for 15 seconds, so even if they don't heal it off of you, you're still going to have that debuff for 15 seconds. If they heal it off of you very quickly, then you won't have to worry about the debuff and not being able to be healed for that duration of 15 seconds. So it's kind of like a win-loss situation. I guess they had to make it different, seeing as how we don't have a ghoul anymore, so they kind of had to punish us for not being able to have that ghoul to sacrifice anymore. Nothing really changed in the level 90 tier. We still, all three of these abilities still act and function the same exact way as they do now on live servers. But here's where the fun starts with our level 100 tier. First up, let's go ahead and start with Necrotic Plague. Now, this is a very lengthy tooltip, and it might seem confusing at first, but it's actually quite simple and a lot of fun at the same time. So let's go ahead and read the tooltip. By the way, this is a passive ability. So, Necrotic Plague is a very powerful disease that deals 248 Shadow Frost damage, and again, they have not done the numbers tuning, so these numbers could possibly change, and they probably won't do the numbers tuning until the last month or so of the expansion actually launches. So, Shadow Frost damage per stack every 2 seconds for 30 seconds. Now notice the word stack there. Each time it deals damage, it gains 1 stack and infects another nearby enemy within 8 yards if possible. You gain 2 runic power whenever a target infected with Necrotic Plague attempts to attack you. Also, replaces Blood Plague and Frost Fever and is applied by any ability which applies either. This effect cannot be refreshed, it gains 1 stack instead. So, let's go ahead and dissect this piece by piece. Let's go ahead and start with the top portion there. So again, this is a very powerful ability, and it deals a crap ton of Shadow Frost damage every 2 seconds for the duration of Necrotic Plague, which is 30 seconds. Each time it deals damage, it gains 1 stack. So every 2 seconds that it is active for the duration of 30 seconds, which is the maximum time that can last on a particular target, it gains 1 stack. So that means that you're going to be getting 15 stacks, a minimum of 15 stacks of Necrotic Plague on a single target. And every single stack, it's dealing an extra 248 damage. So this is a very, very powerful disease. Oops. It also infects nearby enemies within 8 yards, if possible, every single 2 seconds that it gains a stack. So this is going to be very good for single target fights. It's also going to be very, very good for AoE fights, because no matter what creature you put it on, it's also going to infect every single target next to him every single 2 seconds. It's going to jump a target one at a time every 2 seconds, but it's still going to be very, very good for AoE. The next portion of this says you gain 2 runic power whenever a target infected with Necrotic Plague attempts to attack you. So this is the PvP portion of the ability. So this could also, I'm not saying it couldn't be good for PvE fights as well, but this is pretty much the PvP portion of this ability. So you could take this into, you know, Arctic Valley or any one of those new PvP zones that they're working on, like Ashran, for instance. I don't really keep up with PvP portion of World of Warcraft all that often, but I do know that this is no doubt a PvP portion of this ability, so that you are compensated for being attacked while Necrotic Plague is on the target, which I think is pretty, pretty cool. Next up, the third portion of this ability says, replaces Blood Plague, Frost Fever, and is applied by any ability which is applies either. This effect cannot be refreshed, it gains 1 stack instead. So, what this portion of the ability says that this is going to replace Blood Plague and Frost Fever outright. You only get one powerful disease called Necrotic Plague instead of Frost Fever and Blood Plague. So you don't want to mess around with this ability. This is a very, very powerful ability. The other part says this Necrotic Plague is applied to a target whenever you try to activate an ability that would normally activate Frost Fever or Blood Plague. So let's say I hit Plague Strike, or I hit Icy Touch on a target, or Howling Blast. Every single one of those abilities would apply Necrotic Plague to my target. The very last portion of this ability says it gains 1 stack every single time you try to refresh this ability, because the Necrotic Plague cannot be refreshed. It lasts for a total duration of 30 seconds. Nothing past that. Even if you try... Okay, so it lasts a grand total of 30 seconds. Even if you try to refresh it with a Plague Bearer, it's not going to work. It just adds a stack to the Necrotic Plague instead. So, basically what this means is that you cannot make Necrotic Plague go any further than 30 seconds, no matter if you hit Festering Strike, no matter if you hit Plague Bearer, no matter if you hit Howling Blast or Icy Touch or Plague, whatever, no matter if you hit Outbreak. It's just going to add 1 stack to however many stacks you have on the target currently. It cannot go past 30 seconds duration. So, even though every single time you try to refresh the ability, though, it's going to add 1 stack to the target. So even though it can't be refreshed, every single time you hit Howling Blast, every single time you hit Plague Strike, every single time you hit, you know, Outbreak or Icy Touch, it's just going to add 1 stack to the target. So this means that this ability is going to be freaking amazing. This ability is possibly going to be getting nerfed, because as it sits right now, all the testing that people have been doing, saying that Necrotic Plague is freaking amazing, and everything else pales in comparison to it, even Defile and Breath of Cinder Gozer, which we'll get here into in a couple of seconds. But for right now, Necrotic Plague is a very, very good ability, a very good talent, and it looks like it's probably going to get nerfed before it hits live servers, because this just sounds OP AF. But it sounds really, really fun at the same time. So if you guys have any questions about this ability, let me know, because it does sound confusing, but when you break it down piece by piece, it's very easy to understand. Next up, we have Defile. Now, this is a very, very iconic Death Knight ability that Death Knights have been wanting for a long time since Wrath of the Lich King. You guys might know, if you played Wrath of the Lich King, you know where this ability's come from. It's an ability that the Lich King had himself, Arthas. And basically what it does, it's a giant Death and Decay, but it's a pool of, you know, like black ooze. But every single time you cast this ability and someone stands in it, the pool expands. So let's go ahead and read the tooltip. It costs one holy rune, it's on a 30-second cooldown, and it has a 30-yard range, similar to Death and Decay. Defiles the ground targeted by the Death Knight. Every 1 second, if there is an enemy standing inside the defile, it deals 916 Shadow Frost damage to them and grows in radius and damage by 2.5%. Enemies standing in your defile deal 10% less damage to you. Replaces Death and Decay. So since this replaces Death and Decay, you have no chance of summoning Death Coil and Defile at the same time, obviously. But this is going to be a very, very, very good PvE ability, as well as a very, very good PvP ability. So the PvP aspect of this would be, you place this on top of a large group of people. Let's take Arathi Basin, for example, where you guys have to capture, you know, the different points on the map. So, you know, you guys are constantly fighting for the different locations on the map, and all the enemies try to rush into you, just cast Defile. The pool is going to expand, and all the enemies that are trying to attack your base are going to be trapped in it, doing a ton of damage and doing a lot less damage to the Death Knight. I guess it would be kind of cool if they did less damage to your entire group or your entire party, but I guess that would be kind of overpowered. But at the same time, at least you get the damage reduction yourself. So just cast Defile. It expands. They're trapped in it for a little bit. I guess they could run out of it. But at the same time, if they run out of it, no, they're leaving themselves vulnerable attack. And they won't be able to defend or attack your base anymore. Defend their base. So Defile is going to be a very, very cool ability. On the PvE side of things, it's going to allow you to basically save yourself from a little bit of damage from adds that are trying to attack you, as well as, you know, do a crap ton of damage to all of the adds all at once. Now, every single time that the pool expands, it increases the damage that the pool is doing. So the more enemies you have in there, the more damage it's going to do overall. So it's not like Death and Decay, where it's just going to do, you know, a flat amount of damage no matter how many enemies are being affected by it. As where with Defile, the more enemies that are in the pool, meaning the larger it's going to expand and the more damage it's going to do overall. So that's a very, very cool ability, and I can't wait to show you guys what it looks like when I show you guys here in a few seconds. Last up, but not least, is Breath of Syndragosa. Now, this is a very, very stupid ability that is probably going to change, I hope, because as of right now, it's completely useless compared to Defile and Necrotic Plague. So Breath of Syndragosa, it kind of acts the same way as Conversion, in which that it costs 15 runic power to activate, and then it takes 15 runic power from your runic power pool that you currently have to continuously activate the ability. So let's go ahead and read the tooltip. Continuously deals 2,112 Shadow Frost damage every 1 second to enemies in a cone in front of you within 12 yards and affects them with a mark of Syndragosa for 6 seconds. You will continue breathing until canceled or runic power is exhausted. Mark of Syndragosa causes you to be healed for 5% spell damage dealt by afflicted enemies. So, again, a useless freaking ability as it stands right now. Not only does it cost 15 runic power to activate, but it's also going to cost you an extra 15 runic power every second that the ability stays active, which means that no longer will you be able to cast Death Coil and no longer will you be able to cast Frost Strike. So you're not going to be able to continue your rotation on a single target boss fight or an AoE boss fight. It doesn't even matter. You're still not going to be able to continue your rotation because all of your resources are being drained by this one single ability. And it's on a 1 minute cooldown, but at the same time, it's not worth using as it stands right now. I could be doing a lot of other things with my runic power than, you know, wasting it on Breath of Syndragosa. Especially when Necrotic Plague is going to be doing, you know, 10 times the amount of damage that Breath of Syndragosa would be doing at any point in the game. Or any port doing whatever the fight. And this is obviously going to be useless in PvP because no one's going to want to spend their runic power on this useless ability. Especially since it's pretty much an AoE ability. So hopefully they change this ability, guys. I don't think it's going to work out very well. And as it sits right now, it's one of the three. It's the most useless one and does, you know, the worst damage out of all of them so far. And a lot of people on the forums would agree with what I've just said, as I've done my research before I did this video. So last up, we're going to go ahead and go through the glyphs, and I'll try to go through these pretty quickly because this video is turning out to be quite long. But next up, we have Absorb Magic. This is one of the new glyphs that increases the total damage absorbed by Anti-Magic Cell by 100%, but Anti-Magic Cell no longer generates runic power. So basically what this means is that you can no longer choose between... You can no longer have all three Anti-Magic Zone abilities on your glyph slots at one time now. They all share the same exact thing, so you can only use one at a time, basically. You can't use or absorb magic and anti-magic shell glyph all both in the same, you know, glyphs at the same time. You can only choose one or the other. So because these are all really, really powerful, and for you to have all three at the same time would just be completely overpowered, apparently, Blizzard. Anti-magic shell glyph, it's still the same. It allows you to absorb all damage up to the absorption limit, but at the same time, absorb magic absorbs 100% of the damage, but it no longer gives you runic power. So it's kind of like a trade-off there. You have to figure out which one you want, depending on whatever, you know, PvE raid boss you want to encounter. All of these are the same. The new one is called Glyph of Empowerment. Your empowered rune rampant also heals you for 30% of your maximum health. I think that this is really good because, you know, currently empowered rune rampanting refreshes your runes and give you runic power, but I guess it's also cool that allow you to get some health back as well when you hit this button. It's kind of like a save all button, or like an oh crap all button when you hit this button. So I think that's pretty cool. I have it glyphed right now. Enduring Affection is not new. Regenerative Magic is not new. Glyph of Runic Power is, though. Whenever you are struck by a moving comparing effect, you will generate 3 runic power every 1 second for 5 seconds. This is basically a PvP glyph. These are not new. Glyph of Dancing Rune Weapon increases threat regeneration by 100% while your dancing rune weapon is active, but reduces its damage dealt by 25%. That's not new. I think Icy Reaper is new, though. The runes you spend on Chains of Ice will become death runes when they activate. Death runes count as any type of rune. Yes, this is a new glyph. They had a lot of new minor glyphs, though. Glyph of Skeleton, I believe that's new. I'm not quite sure. I haven't played Unholy in a long time, but it looks like most of these glyphs are pretty old. But I think Glyph of Skeleton may be new. I could be wrong. I know Glyph of Geist is old, but I'm not too sure about Glyph of Skeleton because I never play Unholy. But anyways, guys, there you guys have it. Since Unholy is the only only spec now that can you know summon a ghoul as a pet. It's marked off saying that these glyphs can only be used if you're in an unholy specialization. So there's that. That's what that red text means. Now that we've covered all the jibber jab, let's go ahead and go. Oh, there's actually a lot of people over there. Let's actually go over here and show you guys what these new abilities look like. So starting with Necrotic Plague, this is a passive ability. So whenever I try to activate one of my abilities that afflicts the disease, you guys will see that it on the target. So we'll go ahead and hit Blood Plague, and you guys can see that the target has been affected with Necrotic Plague. So every single time I try to refresh the ability by hitting, you know, one of my abilities that does that, like Blood Plague, Howling Blast, it's going to keep increasing the amount of damage or the stacks on the target. Now again, the ability only lasts 30 seconds. So no matter how many times I try to refresh it, it's just going to keep adding stacks to the ability. So Frost Fever, Blood Plague, and there you guys have it, a maximum of 15 stacks. Is that in the ability? It is not in the ability. So I guess it goes to a maximum of 15 stacks, even though it said it doesn't really say that in the tooltip. But I'm guessing that, you know, having Plague Bearer and Necrotic Plague would be kind of OP. So, you know, Plague Bearer, it adds the duration of your normal diseases. But since has Plague Bearer active, or since I'm using Necrotic Plague, it's not gonna refresh. It's just going to add a stack. So I guess it goes up to a maximum of 15 stacks. So you guys, that's what it looked like, guys. It's kind of like a green aura right now on the target. You guys can see it. Well, it's really hard to see right there, but there it is, guys. Let's see if I can find an empty training dummy where people aren't all attacking at the same time. Here we go. Here's an empty one. So there it is. The green skulls right there. Hopefully you guys can see that. Howling Blast. There's the green skulls again. So not a really cool animation. Maybe it'll change. Who knows? But that's what it looks like as of right now. Next up, let's go ahead and try out Defile. I'm in combat. There we go. So let's go ahead and find my ability. There it is. It replaced my Death and Decay. So we're going to go ahead and hit Defile. Ooh, I like ye. As you guys can see, it's slowly expanding as it engulfs more creatures or the more target dummies. That was really cool. It's on a 30-second cooldown, so I'll have to wait a couple seconds before I can show you guys again. Howling Blast. I should have implied Outbreak first. I'm stupid. Frost Strike. Howling Blast. Obliterate. Howling Blast. Pretty much the two-handed frost rotation has not changed at all. Well, basically, dual frost rotation hasn't changed at all. Anyways, they didn't do anything to frost and unholy rotations at all. And it's kind of boring, but I guess we'll just have to live with it. Again, guys, here is what Defile looks like. I have my computer, I have this game set up to the maximum ultra settings that I could possibly set it to. So that is the complete animation. It's not like chopped off or anything like that. So there's my graphic settings. Everything is set to ultra. Projected textures enabled. FXAA anti-aliasing. So that's what it looks like. Next up we have Breath of Syndragosa. You cannot change talent choice while Defile is on cooldown. What? Oh, okay, that makes sense. Alright, so Breath of Syndragosa, let's go ahead and find it in my skill book here. There it is. Alright, so I'm gonna it costs runic... What the frick is that? It costs runic power to cast, so I'm gonna have to build some runic power here. Howling Blast. Obliterate. Howling Blast. Horn of Winter. Horn of Winter. Obliterate. Okay. Howling Blast. There we go. There he is. Breath of Syndragosa. Wow, that's an awful ability. It exhausted all my runic power. Obviously, I don't have a recount because the add-ons aren't enabled in this portion of the beta just yet. But as you guys can see, the animation wasn't that great. And it definitely could have used some work. Ooh, I see that Horn of Winter was changed a little bit. The Death Knight blows the Horn of Winter, increasing attack power of all party ring members with 1,000 yards by 10% for 1 hour. So no longer will this ability grant runic power, which is a shame. Alright, so Breath of Syndragosa is still on cooldown for another 14 seconds, so we'll just have to wait. But as of right now, I think the Necrotic Plague is a very cool ability that just sounds really, really awesome every single time you try to use it. Okay, here we go, guys. Breath of Syndragosa. I know you can't do it yet. Alright, so it was exhausted. There you guys have it, guys. That was all of the new talents and the new glyphs so far for Death Knights on the World of Warcraft Warlords of Draenor expansion and beta. If you guys have any questions for me, just go ahead and let me know in the comment section below. My name is GamerLCD. Follow me on Twitter at GamerLCD. Also follow my live streams at twitch.tv/GamerLCD. Going to be streaming a lot of World of Warcraft Warlords of Draenor beta pretty soon here. Also, I'm going to be streaming the new Naxxramas expansion for Hearthstone starting on Tuesday as soon as it launches. So go ahead and follow me there. There'll be links in the description as well as an armory link to my live Death Knight. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.